Hi, welcome to Georgia Wild. I'm Trina Morris, and today we're going to talk about giving your neighborhood bats a safe home. Whether you want bats to move out of your house or you want bats to move into your yard, a bat house might be the solution. There are four major things to consider when thinking about building a home for bats: design, temperature, location, and timing. Design is critical. Whether you buy a bat house or build your own, the designs should be certified by Bat Conservation International. The most successful bat houses are a minimum of 20 inches tall and 14 inches wide with a landing pad. Taller and wider houses are even better, but the roost partition should be spaced so that there is a 3/4 inch chamber for the bats to roost in. It's best to avoid pressure-treated wood because it may contain chemicals harmful to bats. You can have simple houses with a single chamber, larger boxes with multiple chambers, or you can even put up a deluxe bat condo that can hold thousands of bats. We have free plans for building bat houses and information about where you can buy a bat house on our website. Temperature is another important factor. Bats need a warm space to raise their young. They look for stable daytime temperatures close to 100 degrees. So instead of putting up your bat house in a shady tree, put it in the sun. Bat houses should be mounted in an area that gets 6 to 8 hours of direct sunlight facing either east or south. Location is also critical for bat houses. Bat houses should be mounted 15 to 20 feet off the ground and should be about 20 to 30 feet from tree branches and other obstacles. They should be placed in areas where the bats can get quickly to cover, like along field edges. It's also good if there's a water source nearby, along with a variety of habitat types, and especially native vegetation. Bat houses do well mounted on poles and on the sides of buildings with good sun exposure. Finally, timing is also important. This is a great time of year to put up a bat house. When temperatures drop, bats will likely move out of houses and into areas with more stable temperatures. If you put up a bat house in the fall or winter, it gives the house some time to age and will give the bats time to check it out in the spring. Patience is important. Bats may not find your house right away, or they may already have a roost that they like better. If you've had a well-designed house up for years but no bats, it may be a good idea to move it and see if the bats like it better somewhere else. Wherever you move it, be sure you're ready for guano when it becomes occupied. It can build up quickly. It's great to use as fertilizer in your garden, but you may not want it stuck to the side of your house. Whether you want bats to move out or move in, I hope you will consider installing a bat house. Watching bats enjoying their evening meal in your yard while you enjoy time outdoors with fewer insect pests is good for everyone. Visit GeorgiaWildlife.com for more information about bats and bat houses. Bye for now, and thank you for helping keep Georgia wild.